Okay, so I'm trying to work on the sound and my beauty, and I guess this is great. I have one eye falling down, but the rest of me is okay. I think it's like a puppet eye syndrome. I think I've mentioned that one before. But what I really wanted to talk to everybody about was about group consciousness and what that means, and is it going to happen? And is it already happened? Has it already happened? And when I say group consciousness, I'm not going to talk about everybody on the whole planet. Hey, we can all think, through like the big brains they had on Star Trek, with the original series. No, I'm not going that far. This would just be a select group, that. And I'm going to try to get into the fact that it could be feasible, possible, and how. Okay, so let's say okay, because we already have in our mind, we bring up people in our mind. We have a sporadic list. Say, well, there's that person I've seen recently, and that one, and this other, and the other. So you kind of have brain synapses that start to devote to those recalls. And so you have like you've essentially like turned on the key and hotwired your system to those particular and it's odd because it is a wavelength, it's a wavelength, but it's a wavelength you've perceived and you've created. When you see a person, even in a magazine, it's a wavelength that you're creating of your concept of that person. Okay, so it's and so now you're like, well, I'm gonna have a head chant with, I'm gonna have a head chant with that person, like let's say I'm gonna talk to, anybody, Pamela Anderson, okay, and so I'm gonna have a head chat with her, or I'm gonna have a head chat with that Jennifer Aniston. I think she head chats a lot in my head. Or lately the Keanu Reeves, he's warm because I've seen a lot of images of him, and he's along that it doesn't have to be, though, when I'm saying wavelength, it doesn't have to be the same wavelength of perceived dominance of I'm gonna have only Democrats in my head. I'm gonna only have Republicans in my head. You don't get that choice. You're not getting that choice at all. It's just anybody, unfortunately. And so I'm believing that this, when we're doing all of this Wi-Fi, we're having all of this action out here on the internet, it hotifies our brain. And all these people are having problems sleeping. It's because we have all these waves zipping around. Okay, and so we have this hot brain, and we're seeing at the same time. So imagine you have like a string through your head, like just any kind, like a thin floss, and it's right through your head, but it's actually a telecommunication wire, and at the same moment, it's. There's what you've seen recently. Okay, you've seen this recently in the news, or you've seen this recently, that person talking on a video. Okay, so all of this, or just even a picture on the internet. So you've seen them, and then you've I don't know, you unfortunately it sinks in, and it doesn't only have to be an internet person, but I like to talk about the internet. So there it is. It sinks in because I'm trying to do group communication here, and how that can eventually happen. Okay, so there it is. It has sunk in that you're talking about this person or that person and the other person, or you have a series of like a collection. Like who have you collected recently online? Literally, like who have you seen? It's all pretty. Outstandingly important, because it creates a concept. Like you're essentially you've created your own store of people, and that's your group, your chat group, whether you wanted them or not in your head. they're there. Okay, so and now here we have the wavelength from the Wi-Fi. Now, so how this can actually happen is these wavelengths, and I don't know if I should say Wi-Fi or it's going to be some other radio sort, but the access of those locations in the brain of that memory of who you've really been dealing with recently. And when I say recently, if you were a Yoda in a cave and the last person you saw was 5 years ago, that's going to be your recent. But if you were just a person right now and you saw, seen like 10, 12 people and organized them and they had some kind of an impact on you, they're a little bit more in your brain right now. So you're going to be on a visual aspect and communication, and especially if you listen to like a vlogger, you listen to a philosophy show, you can really start having, you know, major conversations, and you know, if you try, and then the psychoanalyst says, well, you're nuts, that's impossible, that would just be your imagination. Well, with all of this hyper strain through, I mean, it can happen. You can hotify, and they will be able to. They will be able to. I mean, for real. Like when we say, "Well, I'm going to go into a chat room and I'm going to chat with this person, this person, this person." They're gonna make it for sure that we even connect. Like, hey, I'm going online. Like literally, I'm going online, and I'm having that connection, and we're having head chat. With those people in that chat room. Now, the problem right now is I think it is the Wild West, and certain people have really strong brain waves anyway, and so they're just out there shooting them around, and so they may stay in your brain for a while, like road hogs, and it's just like, get the hell out of my brain, I don't want to think about you anymore. So you can have just little piggies that stay there. And then in other instances, you'll be like, I really wanted to like head chat with that person a little bit, but they're just not there. So they can't be, they're just not available. So I believe that we already have this telekinetic, like a kinesis, aspect anyway, yet some people are already hotter than others. So yeah, and I'm not going to say, oh, you're a shaman, because you can head chat, but I believe the internet has really pushed the head chatting skills, so to speak. Now when you're saying, but I haven't had a conversation with you, I haven't head chatted with you like, you know, verbatim, you know, we're not just like, I'm not having this, you know, and you went to the park and then you walked your dog, and I didn't have that kind of conversation. You know, it's more of a wavelength conversation, and unfortunately it's becoming a strange odd, that's all we get in Satisfy as our future goes forward, is we're having wavelength conversations of, I'm pretty sure that, you know, there's no doubt in my mind that's the human being on the retort. I mean, it can all be skewed, of course. It can all go, oh no, never that way. It was not that conversation. And you could be completely misperceiving that head chat in your imagination, because your imagination is still being accessed. Anytime you're even having a conversation, your imagination is still showing up, even with yourself. If you're talking to yourself in the mirror, it's your imagination is there, you know, I'm just laughing. Anyway, So what I'm saying is eventually it's going to get fine-tuned. So we're going to be able to say, hey, they go the meta, the guy's going meta mad over putting people in meta situations. Well, I believe it's going to go further than that, and we're going to actually have access relay that will just how it's going to happen, how it's going to seek and find us each. I don't think it's anything to do with meditation. I don't think we're going to be sitting there going om. We can, of course, have you can have that, the meditation group, join a group together and do that. But that's not what I'm saying. It's not going to be that type of head chat. It's going to be something more almost it's just your brain thought. Okay, it's your brain thoughts, yet able to see and hear within your own mind other people and their conversation in return. So it's going to be a strange, odd, and how is that conversation in return going to happen? Because of all the wire that is less, the wireless that is flowing through, it's literally going to pluck at us like just like, and he would say that, and she would say this, and then return it. So let's say you're asking a question, do you think this guy is really that beautiful today? This little wave is gonna head out because you're in the chat room with me. It's gonna head out and go pluck, pluck, pluck at your brain and bring back that truth. Okay? It's gonna be truth. I don't think you're gonna be able to lie through it too much. So it's gonna bring back that truth that yes. Now, can I hear the person say it also? That yeah, it's blue. I don't know. I don't see why not they cannot have that skill also to bring that through the wave. So it's just I'm talking about literally tapping into other people's brains, going knock, knock, knock on the door, saying, give me the answer, and sending it back and receiving it. So this is really maybe the Star Trek was true, and we're gonna end up in exactly this talent. And it's not a fun talent if you have it already, and you're like in the Wild West. Where just anybody that my mom, she always said, I don't want you watching movies. I don't want you, certain movies, especially when I was younger. Anything R-rated. She didn't want me seeing anything scary. She just wanted me to remain like a pure and innocent human being. She didn't want the hell scenario interference. And you can get that from people. And you can get that from watching things. It comes into your mind's eye. And your mind's eye goes churn, churn, churn with it. And then you end up going, well, great, now it's stuck in my brain, and you want to sue people because you saw it. It's like, I can't stand it. How dare you do that? How dare you plant that into my head? So yeah. So right now I just think it's the Wild West, and those who are really acutely in tune are already head chatting essentially along those wavelengths, and we're already going and knocking on each other's brains and having to go and lock doors and in those chats and say, I'm tired of you, I don't want to talk to you anymore. All of that's going on. And some people are very, very, very good at it, and some people are just you're like, no, no, we're medical establishment. We never heard of anything like that. And you would be a witch or some shamanic, demonic order. And when in reality, all our brain is electrodes. They're little electrode waves that, going back and forth. It's electric energy. And so you're saying, okay, wireless is coming through, and you're gonna say all this little energy is happening, and you're gonna do what? You're gonna ask questions on it. One question to another. I don't see why not. It's just brain tapping. Okay, so there it is. I let the goose out of the bag. On how that one's going to be, and thank goodness the goose is free out of the bag. What else did I have to say? There was something neat with the future. Also, it wasn't just the brain tapping, and I'm not thinking it's going to be that neat for everybody, because we can really start to feel. Invaded, especially if it's the wrong people. So I'm dealing with the drinks. Okay, when I say the drinks, I literally mean they will be making concoctions that we drink, and they will turn us either hyper feminine or hyper male. We will go one or the other. So we will literally take a drink. You know how right now they have like the bull or the red, yeah, they call it Red Bull or some energy quick or whatever. So they do that. So they'll take one of those and it'll turn them into, well, with that one, it would make you like a man. And so if you were a woman, you would get really like demanding and dominant and never want to bake a cake, all of those things. Would just start to turn up because you drank the drink. So essentially, there'll be gender elixirs. So with gender elixirs, we're going to be like, no, I don't want to be that much of a man today. I need more feminine, okay? And I'm not talking about we're going to just have estrogen or whatever, because I think they do that with women a lot. They give them the estrogen. So then they'll have the girly drink. And then all of a sudden you're just like, oh my gosh, I'm feeling so feminine now, and you know, and that's gonna go on, so and then you can have men doing the same. They will take the feminine drink to be much more gay, and then you'll have the women take the man drink to be much more. I don't even know what you call gay women. Gay, I guess, but yeah, that one. And so then you'll have the, you know, what do you want to be today? I'm gonna go work out at the gym. I need to get real strong. I drink the man drink. I mean, you could do that, but it's gonna be that way. They're gonna be nuts over our gender changing and manipulation. And it's instead of just saying, hey, you know, I just wanted to be me and I was born this way in this life, it's going to be, no, I want to manipulate. And just like you put, you know, your makeup on, I want to manipulate who I am. And I'm going to go work on the car. I'm going to take a man drink. I'm going to go shopping. I'm going to take a woman drink. So all of these things are going to start to be our future. So anyway, so that was all I was covering today, were those two topics. And that's that.